So this is a what's called a box baler. It's a wooden box baler. You can also get metal fabricated box balers. There are a few manufacturers out there, but they're pretty expensive and they're also pretty heavy. This is a wooden box baler that I made with one of my students' help. It's also pretty heavy, but can definitely move it through the woods with a little bit of work. There's a couple of sets of plans out on the internet that you can use to help you build your pine straw baler, a wooden one like this one. We actually used those sets of plans kind of as a guide, and then we made some modifications based on things that we saw when we actually tried to use it in the field to improve it. Some of those modifications you'll see on this baler and other modifications we made on a second baler that we built about a month or two ago. So I'll talk about those kind of as we go through it. So you see that it has kind of the box part right here. This is where you actually put the pine straw in. It has this platform out front, and a lot of times people say, well, why does it have to have this platform out front? It doesn't. You can actually build it without it, or you can build it with a slightly shorter platform if you'd like. The main thing is this kind of gives it some stability so that when you actually compress the pine straw, it kind of keeps it from tipping over. You can make it somewhat shorter if you want to. This is also an area where the pine straw can actually, when you open it up and the pine straw bale falls out, it falls out onto this platform. Again, kind of a personal preference. You then have the handle. This is the handle. It's made out of a 2x4 that is attached to the plunger. This is the plunger here that goes down into the canister to press the pine straw down. We did modify the plunger from what the original plans that we saw. We just made it out of a couple pieces of 2x4 here and then bolted on two here. The plywood ones that we used early on, we baled a few bales of pine straw and they broke. We tried some stronger plywood and they also broke. So we opted and kind of made this change here to the plan. We also had to reinforce our handle a little bit too because we had it to break early on. So what happens is you have the canister part here. It has a door on the front. We have a barrel bolt on this one so that the door opens. We, on the new one that we made, we actually took and just made like a crossbar. We have two modified it, so we actually on either side have two metal arms that come out and then just a wooden 2x4 piece that goes down over that. That we found is working a little bit better than this barrel bolt because as temperature changes, as humidity changes, the wood will shrink and swell. And some days the barrel bolt opens really easily and some days not so much. So when you're out there and you're really trying to make good production or baling pine straw, you want life to be easy. So why make it be a struggle? So we adapted so that we don't use a barrel bolt, but really just use a crossbar piece that moves a lot easier. So the pine straw actually goes in the top here. You actually close this down, lock it, you put the pine straw in, and then you compress it. But I'll show you a little bit how you actually have to set it up before we get started.